today I have my very first ever Dreamer Designs diamond paintings. I'm going to go ahead and kind of give you my first impressions using both of these. So this video might be a little bit longer than my normal first look videos, but I want to really give you my first impressions from shipping to quality and drills and everything, canvas and all that in one video. And I'll just go ahead and show you both of the designs that I picked. I actually have a second shipment coming in tomorrow, so I'm excited to show you those as well. But for now, I went ahead and I had never ordered from Dreamer Designs before. Of course, like everybody, I've seen their ads, I've seen their videos. It wasn't that I didn't think they were a reputable company, because I could tell that they were, but they didn't have a lot of designs. In fact, they had probably like 12 designs, and I liked a couple of them, but they were so pricey and I just couldn't go ahead and just, I don't know, splurge. I knew I could trust Diamond Art Club, you know, because I ordered a lot of those before. So it's like anything else. Once you take the plunge, then you kind of get addicted, because you feel like, oh, well, they're a good reputable company. I can trust them. And you kind of just go buy everything. But so let's get started with this. First of all, I looked at these and I was like, okay, where is the design? I can't tell by keeping it in the box where the design is. And finally, I realized it's on the bottom. So this one is the Tawny Owl, and it is super cute. I mean, just colorful, fun, vibrant. And so I chose that one. And I also got this one. It is the Scarlet Macaw. The reason I picked two is because they had a special, and this is another reason I went ahead and just kind of took the leap of faith and purchased something, is they had a buy one, get one 50, which basically gave me a 25% discount on both. So that was a good deal. They were $39.99 each to begin with, and then with the extra discount. Now, I did pay for shipping, because I didn't realize if I ordered $75 worth, I was going to get free shipping. And I pushed this order through and went, what was I thinking? You know, that's why the next day before that special went away, I ordered two more and got the free shipping with the second order. So anyway, this is how they're boxed. They are wrapped in plastic. I will open one of these at a time, and then we'll continue to talk about each item and, you know, what I think about. One other thing before I start getting into the canvases and showing you what the contents are, I'm just gonna tell you, it took about 5 days to get these, to receive these. I'm in the US and I'm in South Carolina. I don't know where these ship from, but I've gotten them and I think it's about 4 or 5 days. And that is including the delay from the postal service because of the coronavirus that's going around, and that was with a delay. So they are fast shippers. Let's put it this way. I feel like a week is probably the longest you're gonna wait if you're in the United States right now. But I did wanna say, this is a fast shipping company. You should have this in less than a week or around a week. Even with delays, it might not take you a week and a half, but that was definitely something I was excited about. You know how we are, instant gratification kind of people. All right, so let's open this up and look at it. I've opened up this box, and when I took off the plastic, I noticed this handle on the side, which I thought was like super convenient. Because I don't know about you, but when I buy diamond paintings, I buy a lot of them. So when I'm moving them from place to place or whatever, that's a handy little packaging design, because then I can transport it, you know, with ease. I can carry quite a few of these at a time. I wanted to show you that because I'm all about package design. But this is what I'm in love with right now. It comes in a mesh tote bag. Like, not kidding you guys, with a purple drawstring. And I mean, I'm talking about transporting or storing or whatever. That is fantastic. So Dreamer Designs recently launched what they call 2.0. And there was a bunch of new designs. There's a totally different, from what I understand, a totally different canvas. Everything is different. This is part of it. I mean, this is just cool. So here's our canvas. Up, nice touch. Somebody's hand tied a ribbon on there. I'm liking it, you guys. I'm all about presentation. All right, the canvas is different. It is not that velvet canvas like the ones that I usually talk about, but it's a really nice quality. It's kind of a slick fabric. And I'm gonna open that in a minute. Sorry, I'm gonna kind of tease you for a little bit with that. I want to see what else is in our bag. Oh my gosh. A little velvet drawstring bag. And I'm sure this is our tools, but I'm excited. I love stuff like this. Okay. Ooh. All right. So let's see what we've got in our little drawstring bag. Wow. Lots of stuff. Lots of goodies. Okay. Baggies for when you open your drills. If you don't have another storage solution, that's what these are for. 2 wax discs in the little containers, which I love that idea. Super excited about those little things. 2 grippers with 2 drill pins. Fabulous. 1 adapter. This is like, I think this is a straightener for like square drills. When you, you know, you push it up against it. I think that's what that is. I haven't even figured that out yet. I'm supposed to be some advanced diamond painter. I guess not. Another multi-drill end to go in that cap. I mean, to go in that end of the drill pin. 3 or 4 drill extension to go on that one. Love it. It's a sparkly little drill pin. They're very cheap pins. I mean, like, this tool is very cheap, but how expensive do you really need it to be? I mean, as long as it serves a purpose. This is a little bit movie, you know, moving around for me, but as long as it stays on when I'm using my drills, I am great with that. I love the fact that they gave you 2 of those. Then we have an amazing pair of tweezers with a cap. And this all, everything in here has Dreamer designs on it. So that is a nice touch. They've logoed everything. That is a super nice, fine point, heavy duty set of tweezers. We have 2 of the trays that I like. You guys know how I am. Oh, they're logoed. Love it. Love it. But you get 2 of them. You know, they're not expensive items, but they're just so much more convenient with the little funnel than the green ones are. And so these are just, you know, I like these better. Now these are small and, but you know, again, I'm okay with that. Let's go to our drills or whatever's left in here. Okay, that's gonna be our drills. Ooh, beautiful. Now this is a square drill piece, which means, you know, it'll take me a long time because I'm slow and I start about 20 projects at a time. But those are gorgeous colors. I'm excited about that. I'm not gonna open those yet. You know how I'm gonna do, set that aside. I'm gonna check those and make sure they're all there once I get to my canvas. But I wanna look at this canvas, okay? So let's roll this bad boy out. Now, one thing I've talked about in other videos with other people's canvases is that when you roll it out, it lays flat. I'm not sure if this is gonna do that. Look at those bright colors. Oh my gosh. So I'm hoping that once I have this laid out and it will flatten on its own, because at this point, I'm not sure it's gonna do that. You see how it's already rolling up on itself? So let me put my light on this corner here. And that's just blocked the whole recording. Jeez Louise. Okay, but that's gonna help a little bit. Okay. Now I'm gonna tell you what we use these at my house for, these foam inserts for the rolling. You can use it for your canvases, but we use these as swords. My 3.5-year-old grandson and I, we each get one of these, and my husband, and we run around and we beat the crap out of each other with these because they don't hurt, they're fun, they're not dangerous, they won't knock something off, and they're lightweight. So we look at these as a bonus when we get one of these with a diamond painting. My husband will say, do you have any new diamond paintings, or do you have any new paint my numbers with those foam swords in it? And so that's what we use these for. Listen, you have to be creative with stuff like this. Okay, especially with a 3.5-year-old that's got a lot of energy. So here's what we have. We have a great printed instruction guide on one side with pictures. And then on the other side, there is talking about their community and their social media and their Facebook and their Instagram and YouTube and everything. So that's what you get in this. And then you get one of these, which I love. You guys know I love these. I'm wondering, it feels like it's got like a sticker backing or something. It may not, but that's kind of cool. I'm gonna check it and see. I probably tear the thing apart, not even meaning to. But this is your schematic. So for me, when I organize my drills before I start, you know, I put them in one of those little divided boxes, and then I use this and put this in that box with my drills. And that way I know what I'm working on, what drills those are for, and it's just a handy little tool. I like it. Okay. But the colors, you guys, oh my God. I'm gonna put these drills up here and weight that corner down. All right. So this is our Tawny Owl. And he is gonna be so vivid, so gorgeous. But let's talk about the canvas for a minute. We have a schematic on the left, schematic on the right. Very easy to distinguish codes. But this is what I want to look at. I want to see how easy these are to read. And I'm going to tell you, I never thought a company would impress me as much as Diamond Art Club does. But this one has got my attention. The only real difference is their packaging is amazing. It's even got the beat, Diamond Art Club beat. But this, this canvas is not velvety and whatever. But in the long run, that is not something that's gonna make or break my opinion of a diamond painting, because I feel like this is a super high quality. It's just different quality. And the Diamond Art Club ones are velvet, but that's a patent they're working on. So it's not like anybody else can really repeat that. But this one, as long as this will lay flat, which it looks like it's already starting to kind of stay flat on its own, if, as long as it'll do that, I'm gonna be extremely thrilled. Let's see how much stick it's got. Now that's easy to come off. Okay, now I'm gonna pause the video so you don't have to hear me crinkling all these drills, but I'm gonna open those drills and we're gonna kind of look at those, because the colors are like life to me. I do know that there are, oh, first of all, let me go back. There's 27 colors in this this painting, this diamond painting. 27 luscious, gorgeous, vibrant colors. But I do know a few of them are aurora borealis, which you know I love. So let me open these and let me lay these out and we'll take a look at them. Okay, I've got them out of the package, and the first thing I'm noticing is they're numbered in order. 01, 02, 03, 04. Oh my God, that is so handy. Especially when I'm putting them in separate containers, I can just go through, and I mean, it'll be super, super easy to do. Let me get through here and I'm gonna unroll them. We're not gonna look at every single color. What I want to look for are the aurora borealis ones. Oh, and it actually tells me on my schematic. Oh, AB08. There's two aurora borealis in this particular piece. AB38. So I know exactly which ones those are. Those are going to be the last two. The lime green. Oh my God, they couldn't have picked a prettier color to put it on. Ah, and the white. Oh, you guys. Oh my goodness. Okay. I hate to say this right now, but I think I'm going back shopping at Dreamer Designs. What I like is that this canvas, I didn't tell you the size. This one's actually a 14 by 50 centimeter, which is equivalent to a 15.7 inch by 19.7 inch, but it's totally doable, which I love. I mean, I love the really big ones. They're so gorgeous and impactful, but I swear sometimes I feel like I'm never gonna finish anything. And I'd like to be able to start one and be able to finish it. I'd be so excited. Let me get this wrapped up and we're going to look at the Scarlet Macaw in this same video so that you can see what it looks like. And I'll be right back with that. Okay, so this is the Scarlet Macaw and it has 30 fabulously vibrant colors, as you can see. This one looks a little larger. Maybe it's the same size. Let me look. No, this is the same size as the Tawny Owl. It is a 40 by 50 centimeter, 15.7 inches by 19.7 inches. And these are licensed art from Sandra Trubin. So they all kind of have that funny, fun, eclectic vibe to them. There's a lot of details you're probably not able to see in the angle that you're looking down here. But I will attach a photo of what this should look like before. And I think you'll see the vibrant colors really come to life, even though they really come to life here. Again, we've got our schematic strip. We won't go through all those kind of details. And I did open the drills already. I was using them to hold down that corner up there. And it looks like, other than a couple, like there's three extra colors in this one, that these colors are so similar to what I was using or gonna be using with Tawny Owl and the other, one of the other ones I ordered, that I'm really excited about that, because then I can organize all of these drills, because it's a square drill. I can organize these drills with all of the paintings that I have from this particular company, but also from this artist, and be able to use them for all of the pieces that I'm getting from her, which I like. So basically what I'm saying is I can take this bag of AB38 and my bag of AB38 from my Tawny Owl and my bag of, you know, AB38 or whatever from the kits that are coming tomorrow, and I can put them all together in one container, and then I don't have to have separate boxes for each of these paintings because they're all gonna go together, which I love that idea. Saves on money because I don't have to buy extra storage boxes, and it also saves on time because I'm not looking around going, okay, which one's for the owl and which one's for the macaw, you know, whatever. This one has three aurora borealis. Let's go here and look at them. There's two of them. And let's see, number 28, right tucked in the middle, wouldn't you know it? And this one here is the other aurora borealis. So there's three on this painting here. Oh, I love it, I love it. Okay, oh my goodness, you guys, I'm gonna stop crinkling for a second, sorry. I'm extremely obsessed right now. I know I have no restraint. I'm about 2 minutes from finishing up this video, and I'm gonna jump online and I'm gonna be ordering me some more of this particular style just because I'm loving it. So I hope you love it too. I'm not affiliated with Dreamer Designs. This is my first purchase ever from them. I'd love to know your opinion. Go to the group and make sure you join, because we can share opinions there of places that we've shopped from. And you guys, thank you as always for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment. Don't unlike, and don't leave nasty comments, because I will block you in a heartbeat. Unlike is just, it's just rude. Like, it really is just hateful. I don't understand why people do that. You spend 15 hours getting a video recorded, edited, graphics done, information typed, uploaded on the computer, and somebody's gonna unlike what you've done. I'm like, well, then you do it, and you do it better. But anyway, there's my rant for the day. All right, you guys, I love you. Hope to see you back soon. Thank you as always for watching, and I can't wait to show you what I've got coming tomorrow.